Paul and Timotheus.
Paul and Timotheus.
The servants of Jesus Christ.
The servants of Jesus Christ.
To all the saints in Christ Jesus.
All the saints in Christ Jesus.
Which are at Philippi. With the bishops and deacons.
With the bishops and deacons.
Grace be unto you.
Grace be unto you.
And peace.
And peace.
From God our Father.
And from the Lord Jesus Christ.
And from the Lord Jesus Christ.
I thank my God
upon every remembrance of you.
Always in every prayer of mine.
For you,
all make requests with joy.
For your fellowship in the gospel.
From the first day until now,
being confident
of this very thing,
that he which has begun a good work in you
will perform it
until the day of Jesus Christ.
I'd like to talk to you about fitted or prepared for survival. I guess there's a time in stepping in a time like this. There are many people today who refuses to get saved and figure the venture. And there's too much opposition to say with confidence, I'll make it through. They feel there are so many obstacles and so many situations that arises and that are all related that we just won't be able to make it. The requirements are too stringent, and the enemy is too potent. So, Apostle Paul here, give us some instructions here. And in fact, he'll give us the recipe as time goes on. He said that now, even it is being confident of this very thing, verse number 6, very thing, that he which had begun a good work in you will perform it to the day of Jesus Christ. Spiritual survival, the survival of the fittest. I guess people sometimes almost become discouraged because every time there's a judgment or there's some infinality, there's always just a handful who survive. Many stars, many do exploits, but they don't survive for whatever reason. You know, there are many animals that you read about not extinct. Because what? Because they could not adapt or cope with the changes. And when something that was beyond the commonplace would come their way, many times they would succumb to it. And only those which apply themselves and use what God had given them naturally survived. There is a built-in survival mechanism in all of us. Listen, you know that God, and what as he is manifest in the Word, would not place us in a hostile world without assuring us of some means of survival. We don't play God chief here. Now, well then the question might necessarily arise, well then why are there so many failures, so many that flunk, and so many that just goes under for whatever reason? Well, they did not take advantage of their natural resources. They did not, amen, apply what God has given them. Right now, the one doctrine and standards that are so vital to us, there you can count them on your hand who are yet holding to them. What? Because they were not equipped, they did not take advantage of what God had given them that would have enabled them to survive. I read about a lot of supposedly prehistoric animals and whatnot, and they are no longer with us. Now, about the saber-toothed tiger and all those kind of things, I like exotic cats, you read about them, because they're interesting. And now, but they're no more. Some of them are historic, and some of them might not have existed. But anyway, they're here no more. And now, and when they become extinct, I mean, that's the end of that. There won't be any more of those. Let me tell you something, no more. If indeed what God has given you, and that conviction, and that fear of God that He placed in your heart, there will be a necessary means of survival. Don't let it come extinct. Don't let it be wiped out. Then you have nothing to work with. There'll be nothing to stir. You follow me? So there is nothing to perpetuate it. You understand? But you'll be shouting today because it's available. It's there. It was given to you. That was a necessary application. God gave it to you. Now you might bemoan your plight and say, I can't make it, but it's because you won't make it, not because you can't. You understand? God knows your frame. Now, none of us knows everything we're going to face in life. And you don't have to know everything. But we know this. God has equipped us for whatever. I know you have some things now that are overwhelming and seemingly almost impossible and all this kind of thing. It's too much for a human and almost inhumane to allow it to come your way. But there's a grace for that, dear one. There is a means of survival for that. Now the devil might blight your mind, you can't see it, and you don't know what pick the turn. But I'm so glad. This is my consolation, that to know that I don't have to live all night long wondering what might come next. That's right. And through what source it might come. All right, Paul wrote this. Read verse 17 up here.
But the other of love,
go on.
Knowing that I am set for the defense of the gospel.
Go on.
What then? Notwithstanding, every way, whether in pretense or in truth, Christ is preached, and I therein do rejoice, yea, and will rejoice.
All right, listen. Paul was speaking here in verse number 16. That are called read.
The one preached Christ.
The one preached Christ of contention, not sincerely.
Supposing to add affliction to my bond.
Wait a minute. The Lord had given Paul a premonition of what he might encounter. You follow me, children? He said, I want to show you, Paul, that I'm going to give you power. You're going to be in the forefront, but you're going to do some things. When you're a use of God, you think that's a showpiece. It was, but if you act and use of God in a real way, you're going through some things from whatever source, from every angle. You're going to go through it. It's going to come from whatever source. Maybe in your home, maybe in your church, maybe in your job, wherever. But you're going to go through some things. What? Because the devil is anti. The devil is anti, and he knows he has to do something to stop you, otherwise he'll wreck his kingdom.
Praise God.
You recognize that. And he knows when you have that capability. And he knows when you are applying what God has given you.
Oh.
You understand? He knows that. And he knows that you're determined and you're resolute. God knows that. And so the devil exalts himself to just eradicate you. Through whatever means.
Oh.
Let me tell you this, one. Don't ever come to a point when you're going through something serious. What?
But where the source that it came from?
Where did it come from? Job's greatest test came from his wife, not from losing the children, all of that. So whatever the case might be, Jesus' great test came before the disciples. They forsook him and fled, betrayed him. Wait a minute, he trod the way before us and gave us a no. Let's read over here. Give me St. John, chapter 16. I believe we want maybe the last verse, St. John 16, if you will. All right.
These things have I spoken unto you.
That in me ye might have peace.
In the world ye shall have tribulation.
In the world you shall have tribulation.
But be of good cheer. I have overcome the world.
Now wait a minute. God, wait a minute. Be at peace. Don't be disturbed here. But because of the foreboding situation that's facing you, don't be afraid. Many people are going to lose their soul because they're afraid of what might happen. They're afraid in some situation they might be overcome, not back out again.
Oh,
amen. and they're being lost with some wild speculation, not applying or not considering what God has provided for them. Now, your situation is not peculiar. It's not something that nobody else has ever had. It's not something that nobody else has survived before you. It's not. Come on with it. I know when I was in seventh grade, we came into those people that could have been suicide, and trying to escape and everything. It was just too much. And I felt sometimes, I'd like to be trying to escape doing something. But when I told him, I said, if anybody else has ever done it, I can't do it. That's all my hand with it. Everybody not doing it. If somebody has the capability and the wherewithal to go through this, so can I. If any man have ever lived perfect, so can you. In the judgment, when people, I just couldn't live perfect. There were so many things came against me. Your sons did it. Noah did it. Job did it. And some people that you know did it. Can you get nothing from it? But without wild speculation. Come on, you pray with me? Pray with me? Listen. And then, when you come up with a situation that is seemingly impossible, I just couldn't stand, it was just too much for me, people said, the Bible says, there'll be those who will rise up in the judgment and condemn you. So they did it. They did it. They did it. Well, there was never, amen, Lord, I had an impossible husband. It was just unreasonable and ridiculous. Well, the sons did it. He went through it and never got out of spirit. Come on. Well, Lord, but you don't know my wife. Well, I don't have to know. I know by grace. I don't have to know your wife. But I know grace. She's a woman. She's a woman. Maybe an unusual woman, but she's a woman. And I have grace for the unusual. Can you follow me? Okay. Don't you let the devil steal your soul. Because you're afraid something might come, the extraterrestrial, that something from way out of space somewhere, and you won't be able to cope with it. No, it's just a moment here. You are despairing the word of God. He said, the good work that he has begun in you, he will perform it. If you just let him, God will perform it. Amen. He's giving you the wherewithal, he will perform it. If you get back and get out of self and quit trying your own course and sitting on the gift tree. Because you just said, dear, I'll perform it for you. You didn't whip all night on biting off your fingernails. I'll perform it. But you just resign yourself. You just trust me. Oh, God. You just trust me and cease from man. That's why you can't sleep because you don't know no man that can rescue you at this point. But just a moment, about to cease from man. And trust exclusively in God. We know many people don't do that. But they're going to come out on the losing end. This, and what God's right, that's all there is to it. Nothing new to it. Or add to it or detract from it. All right. Jesus said, what now? That letter for you just read in St. John chapter 16.
These things have I spoken unto you.
That
in me ye might have peace.
Ye might have peace.
In the world ye shall have tribulation.
In the world ye shall have tribulation.
But be of good cheer.
Uh-huh.
I have overcome
it. Now I have overcome it. And I'm the example. And if I have overcome it, then I'm going to give you grace to overcome. And God help if you don't accept it. Come on. See, you're going to have tribulation. And we don't know where the source of it. You're going to have tribulation. You don't know where it's coming from. It might come from those that you least expect. Something that you wouldn't imagine that it could come from them. You understand? Well, I've done this for you. Now I picked you up when you were down. All this, you turn against me. But so what? The people. You do it to people. That's the way people are. That's what I say to you. Don't put your confidence in princes. Don't put your confidence in man. Trust God.
Amen.
Now, but last time, doctor, you were successful. But this time, you said you can't stop the bleeding. Now you're coming and I came all the way to New York. Because you were a specialist of the first magnitude. Well, in your case, I'm sorry. Sorry, call your family in. Listen, it's in your life. You better pray pretty hard. Listen. Please don't allow the enemy to bright your hope or call you to shimmer in fear. Because you're afraid that something might arise that will overwhelm you. and it's working, and you are succumbing because there are so many other people succumbing to it. But you don't have to. But that's when you read the Word of God. When you read the Word of God, what do you do? Just to say I read the Bible this morning, or just to say I had devotion? You really didn't want to apply it, and to accept it, and to trust in it, and to rely on it. And doubt is necessary. All right. Now, talking about survival. And now they have many endangered species of animals. Means now, and they have a great bounty, gold, and if you violate, then you get a great penalty for killing those animals, because what they just a few of them left, and maybe in the wild, a few, and they come just in the wild, where there was one time thousands, maybe millions of them, but now in the wild, maybe a couple of hundred at best, and they're in captivity, and some don't breed in captivity. And then you won't see those things anymore. It's all over. What you've enjoyed, going to the zoo and seeing all that kind of thing, if it becomes extinct, you won't see it anymore. That glory you had in your soul, that joy, my God, let it become extinct, you won't see it anymore. When you trust in God, believe in God, and you saw the work of God, and you witnessed the move of God in your soul, that fire you saw burning down inside constantly, you won't feel that anymore if you become extinct. If you become extinct, try to rekindle it. Now, as I say, you become extinct. But now, sometimes there might be a lingering ember. There might be a dying ember. And you might be able to fan it and put some paper on it. You can get some candy with it and some log to go with it. That paper on it is strong. You understand? Now, if there's an ember, if there's a dying ember, that's why we're trying to rescue you before you go too far. Because if you lose that ember, if there's nothing there to ignite, reignite your little substances. Well, then let me tell you something. You lose it. That's why the Church of God and Reformation movement is in apostasy. But they went so far, and now they cannot revive. We got a great big invitation now. Maybe the last shot. And I'm looking forward to praying for the to go to the congregation we came from. They invited us. They sense where they are. And I'm wondering if there's anything that's disturbed. I said, Lord, what do we do? How do we approach it? How do we approach it? They don't need reminding. They don't more hit more about the history of history than we do. They got books, same books. You got Beers, Byron, and Warner. They got those books. Seven Seals books and all. They have all of those. So go in there trying to preach that to them. That's not the way to do it. Go in there trying to hit on their exact point, their weak point. One, just take a word that. They're the kind of anointing and the kind of enlightenment that you must possess. There's something that you must have to impart to them. Not to go there and blast them about that and the other. They know all that. That's what they call you. Because they need help. They need help. You understand, children? You know, I was in Atlanta. I went to a church there. And one of them was a preacher. He said, oh, Lord, if I could just feel that fire that I used to feel. But at least his sister didn't have any longer. Some people go on and try to get a false fire and try to substitute. No, that's not the same. Foxfire is different than real fire. Foxfire is something stuff that you see in the dark that's not really genuine. It's something that's there, almost imaginary. You follow me? See? So what do you do? That's why you get up at sometime 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning before God. I want to put the wood on the fire. I feel like I'm drying up in my soul, Lord. I don't get the witness that I used to get. I've been a while since I got a real clear witness. And crying before God. And going on a 3 or 4 day fast to recapture what now your sister's absent. Because not that diligent anymore. Whether you want to come back, you'll work yourself out. Whether you won't work yourself out. Or you work out your own salvation. You can't save yourself, but you got to work it out. Salvation is a gift, but you got to work it out. You can't work for it, but you got to work it out. That you're just, it's individual. Work out yourself, your own salvation, not mine, not somebody else's. I can't work it out for you. There's something I can see in your soul, but you got to work it out. You can accept or reject it. I don't care who brings it. Come on. I got to work out mine. I have an obligation. I'm not extinct because I preach it. I got an obligation to keep my fire burning, despite all of the difficulties that might come my way. You said, listen, in the world, you're going to have it. You're going to have tribulation. Now, you know what is so sad? Many people get in a dire situation and they're back against the wall and come to the church for refuge. Dear one, let me tell you this. Jesus said, I have overcome it. I survived it, and so can you. I survived it. I had everything imaginable to come my way, and I survived it, and so can you. And I'm going to be with him the same thing that I have. I survived it. I looked to God. I had some adversities. Amen. He even wept. Come on, you know, I think one occasion, one or two. I can't tell you when you finally wept. Listen. I survived it. Tribulation, see, that's across the table. That's not just one instant or one event. That might be a conglomeration of things. I survived. I survived all of it. The devil threw the book at me. But I survived. And so can you. So can you. And then, too, well, you got to counsel that. Wait a minute. What about the grace that I gave you? Now, you can't just let yourself go and that's just me. I just have those times, those bells, and some of that moon change, and on the when the moon has moon, I go off. You can't do that. And the moon off of everybody. Even wrong time of the month, you can't do that. You can't do that. I just get up some jittery when that comes. So I got to make some sprinkle out of it. When you change everything, you never gonna drive you to the whole bottle of it one time.
It's like washing
over. Overcome. Listen. Now, when the Lord sent the disciples out, he knew their weakness. This is before Pentecost. But he gave them what was necessary to survive. He was a sheep among wolves. He knew what to face. Turn to Luke chapter 10, verse 18 and 17. Quickly. All right.
And the 70 returned again with joy.
What?
And the 70.
The 70.
Returned again with joy.
Returned again with joy.
Saying, Lord.
So Lord.
Even the devils are subject unto us
even
through thy name.
Even the devils are subject unto us.
Through thy name.
Go on.
And he said unto them.
Yeah.
I beheld Satan as lightning falling from heaven.
Falling from heaven. Now that don't mean the devils are in heaven. Three don't come from heaven. You know how lightning is sudden. He's as lightning. When you say so, him falling. As. Come on.
Behold,
yes.
I give unto you power
yes.
to tread on serpents and scorpions.
Now, wait a minute. Now, the devil will be going to be arrayed in full power. But I've done what?
I give unto you power.
I give unto you power.
To tread on serpents.
I give you power to survive everything the devil might throw at you. Devil, demons, and his demons, or whatever. I give you power. And you give it less one if you submit yourself. We are inexcusable. God, you go on among devils, a very imaginable sort. Every spirit in the book, legions, and everything else. But I'm going to give you power to overcome them. I'm going to give you the wherewithal to survive. But then what if I tell you something? Now, any of us that ever had failure and fall, you had to call the spirit of women. And you submitted. Come on. And you do it again. If you don't get that survival power, I don't care who you are. I don't care how strong you were at one time. I don't care how much you preach, how much you sing, whatever you do. You better pray hard. I'm going to tell you the truth. And then I think people cry, Lord, it's just, a lady in your court, she's so in love with me. But she, one time she got upset when he was her revival. I didn't mean to do that. I loved him. How I loved him. You loved him. He did. Past tense. Come on. But it was, she thought because of her affection that could not happen. And that came upon her, and she couldn't survive that impulse that caused her to do it. And many people can't be saved. The impulse comes up to sometimes just give a heat to a getting mad spirit and go off on somebody. They say, God, forgive me afterward. You don't do that. You get there back in the corner and you come out any way you can. Legal or illegal. Legitimate or illegitimate. You come, I'm coming out. Just a moment. You don't do that. You don't do that. But you trust God. That's what you claim you're doing. For everything, not just one thing. I've overcome the world, and I'm going to give you power to survive. I'm going to send you out, but I'm not going to send you out empty-handed. I'm not going to send you out without the wherewithal to do what you should do to accomplish your purpose. I'm not going to send you out to be destroyed. God don't let you go through something to destroy you. Please help us. That is an affront to the character of God. Because I'm sending something to strengthen you and to enhance my kingdom. So when you go through, others will be encouraged by your standing. I'm not sending you out there to destroy you or to mock you. I'm sending you out to represent me. You better pray pretty hard. And I'm just sending you out to just fight in your own power, in your own mind, with your own resources. I'm going to give you that to survive. I'm going to give you that to survive. And when you look back from eternity and say, Lord, I just couldn't make it. Wait a minute. I'm going to give you an instant replay of your life. And you could have survived. See here? Yeah? And when you got guts, you just start trembling, and you didn't want to say something, man, you could have done it. That was not the spirit. That was to keep you saved. I gave you a right hand to do that. I got a little rough with you. So I'm going to let you do it. Come on. I gave you enough gas, go around the block until it stops in that sister's house. But you put your foot on the gas. Come on. I gave you some brakes. You could have stopped. You let the brake go out. So you couldn't stop. But you did it. You got out on foot. Children, let me tell you something. You better pray. You're going to lose all your young people and all your children if you're not careful in this age. All these spirits are so available that they're running rampant. They're running amok. These spirits are. But okay, this situation. Now, you know why many of them don't get saved? I don't think I can live like that. Well, even though they might have seen you live like that. But this is not for me. This is not for me. They'll tell you that. Not for me. You had your chance. I wonder what it's all about. And when they learn, they're in an ear or unfixable mess. Why is it the Bible remember you created in the days of your youth? Why don't they do it? Well, because they think they're missing something and they're impelled by a spirit and they think they don't have a wherewithal to withstand those spirits. So they're gonna try it. Well, I love them, you know, and they did, you know, they came up from the same teaching and did that. We're dealing with something here. And you're gonna be made a weep if you're uncareful. If you don't get it over to them and pray hard, like the Bible word of God says. I'm gonna tell you. We got a job on our hands and not to regenerate and try to enhance our living style. You got a responsibility right at home. And it's vivid and apparent enough. God help us out here. God help us. What do you say?
Behold. I give unto you power.
I give unto you power to survive all those things that come against you. Yes. Listen, when you go out and witness and all that kind of stuff, you don't know somebody might fuck you. Don't be afraid of seeing this afternoon. Experiment we had. We were out in the sun. See, I had a few self-made chairs on you, maybe 8 or 10 members. And so, and a guy came out of the store. Didn't know that's how I feel about it. But it was automatic. But he didn't share this, but I mean, he mimicked it. And didn't know how he felt and what he would have done if he had it. That was our first encounter. Well, then, why did you stop? If they did that kind of threat, well, God gave us grace to keep on. We're under his auspices. When his care, what do you mean? Don't you know when you in God's care, God makes himself a committee of one to see through safety. You plead, oh No, not God. If God sent you in line, then he'll just take you and go with him. If God sent you in front of you, he'll go with you. If God sent you wherever, he'll go with you. He'll just leave you out there and watch you perish. God help us out here. Amen. Amen. Our estimation of God seems to be warped here. Amen. If God allows this in your way, he'll go with you. We sing a song sometimes, if Jesus go with me, I'll go anywhere, anywhere. Why? Because that's our security. That's our means of survival. Now, well then why are there so few? They don't prepare themselves to survive. They don't use the resources that God has given them. They're trying to make it in the world. They're trying to make themselves comfortable for a future that's not theirs. And you don't pray heaven, you don't pray heaven with the devil. But you're going to be all for God if you're going to survive. He knew all in every detail. Not symbolically, but all in every detail. All right. What did he say?
Behold, I give unto you power.
I give unto you power.
To tread on serpents and scorpions.
All of those opposing elements. And you're going to have them. I don't care how good you are, how holy you are. You're going to have them within and without. You can assure that. And that's grief. Well, where's the safe place? Well, there aren't any, only in Jesus. What? Jesus got crucified. Paul beheaded. And many others died in ignominious death. So so what? But they were perpetuating the cause of God. They survived all that they sent their way, and they didn't recant. They didn't recant. They were going to give their lives in the back of an inch. So if you don't know, if they had saved their life, they would have lost it anyway. Because they wouldn't mean nothing, they wouldn't mean nothing to the kingdom. So we got that messed up on us. Did we see it through? All right. Give me 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse number 7. All right.
Unless
I shall be exalted
above measure through the abundance of the revelation, there was given to me a thorn
in the flesh,
the messenger of Satan to buffet me.
Listen, dear one, what happened? Why you come and sit for that bank? They just kept coming against me. Well, in the church. There was a message of Satan, but it was in the church. Because that's where he was, in the church. A message of Satan directed from the devil, an emissary of the devil, if you will, to buffet him, to destroy him. The only time I've seen Paul crowd like that was on an occasion. Three times he sought God, not just praising God, help me, sought God. Did everything he knew to get hold of God and get this thing reversed. At this moment, here we go again. Let me show you. Don't you let the devil turn you against God, or doubt God, because you prayed earnestly for something and it didn't come the way you expected it, or the way you wanted it. The hardest, the most difficult situation Paul had gone through, he prayed and didn't get the answer he wanted. He wasn't moved. But he still trusted God, even though his prayer was not being answered, despite all of the effort and the sacrifices he was doing. I'm going to tell you, you got to study the way of God, so you miss it. Let me tell you. Anyway, he said, well, okay, now I'm praying, I'm fasting, I'm praying, now, and the devil still, you let him come and stick that thorn deep and deep in my flesh, and so I'm barren. You know that, Lord. I can't take much more. And you're allowing it to happen. And you can stop it! You gonna pray? You pray hard. I'm gonna tell you, you can disallow it. But you don't have been to go through all this. I've been going through everything you sent my way. And Lord, I want this to be the exception. I still get out and say, you must suffer. You didn't go through this blindly. Mm-hmm. And what happened?
But this thing I besought the Lord thrice.
Go ahead.
That it might depart from me.
All right.
And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee.
Wait a minute now. Let's take it easy. Paul, don't go off here. Now, don't enumerate how you saw it and what you did, otherwise you get a case against God for yourself. I prayed, Lord. I did all you said. I read the Bible. I got anointed. Wait just a minute, G. Wait just a minute now. You didn't come. Wait a minute. Did you lie to you? How many times did you see God in this fashion? You understand? Did you exhaust all the resources that God had given you down in your soul? This is no game. We're in a battle here. This is a real conflict we're dealing with here. God help us out here. This is a superficial social religion. You know, God help us out here. We don't want to get blind here and see what the, and not see what the battle is all about. Really, shouldn't it? That's why it's so survival. All right then. What did he say?
And he said unto me.
Said unto me.
My grace is sufficient.
My grace is sufficient for you.
For my strength is made perfect in weakness.
My strength. Now, I'm going to show you something. I let you go through it to show you the ability and what I got, my strength. In your most distressing hour, when doubt and fear, doubt is bombarding your mind, my strength will be perfect in you. You couldn't have got it otherwise. You couldn't get it to another source. You can't get it to reading a book. You have to experience it. Now, I just want to show you that in a situation that when all of your support seems to be gone, even for me, because you prayed, kept on praying three times, and you didn't get the results you were looking for. And I know you attempted to retract and to get a case against God. But listen, then you never would have known my strength. There's something vital that you never would have experienced. You don't know when God taking you through, and you don't go through, you miss plan and miss something vital. Something that's gonna sustain you in time to come, in that decisive one. I'm going to tell you faith. You don't know. Listen. You don't know what God might call you to. And you can't touch your own course. Some might never get a wife. But you're going to back out if you'll come back in 4 weeks. Years. Decades. We stop there. There was silence in the heaven about this basis. 1 hour. Read a little more.
And he said unto me, My grace is sufficient for thee.
My grace is sufficient. Wait a minute. Hold it. Wait, just a minute. Read that again. What's the language here? Come on.
My grace is sufficient for thee.
For thee. Not for everybody, not for the air, but for thee. Not for the atmosphere. Not for no particular company, but my grace is sufficient for thee. Now, I know you think you might be going through an unusual situation. Maybe there's something that might have taken you out of you might, but my grace is sufficient for thee. He's personalizing here, but for you in particular. I have a grace just fitted for you. Just fitted for your survival. And I want to use it. And I want you to go far enough to allow me to use it. Everybody wants to survive. Next one might be more difficult. Little friend. Well, you know what? I don't know if it's a day. Unless maybe somebody slipped my mind sometime. That I don't do my faith maybe before they calling on God for you all in particular. I don't mean bless everybody in the world, all the same. I mean your name. Sometimes I may miss one that called out a little later. Because I know what you're going through. And if you intend to survive, but now I can pray myself to death if you don't accept the results of it. But then of course that's on you. You understand what I mean? And God burns our heart. That's what I'm living for now. I have no limitation in life. I mean that. I have no other aim, no other goal in life. I mean that. And that's it. And God knows God will step in, make that kind of declaration if I hadn't waited. I mean, I have no utopia that I'm looking for. There's no perfect state I'm looking for. I don't care if God will give me the blessings that I can imagine. God forbid that I murmur to sin before God. There's a tremendous thing we're dealing with here. What did it say?
My grace is sufficient for thee.
All right.
For my strength is made perfect in weakness.
Listen, you won't know what I'm all about unless you trust me. My strength is made perfect in weakness. When you're at your lowest point, that's when I can prove my ability to bring you out. And you'll never know that if you don't go so far.
That's right.
If you have limitations, amen, you'll never know this. You'll never experience this. This is what you miss, and it's vital. And it's essential. So hang there with it. And let the thorn hurt. I know it's hurting. I know it's too quick. I understand that. But I'm letting it sink in deep so I can show you my strength and show you what my grace can do, even if I don't take it away. How much of y'all got grace to survive it? You got to get some experience with God, children. I'm going to tell you something. And you got to get some experience with God. And you don't just get it through teaching. I can preach myself to death, but you got to experience something for yourself. You understand? Oh, come on, Diane. I know we get some good preaching, but you got to have some good experiences. You're going to need more than good testimony, good preaching, and good books. You're going to need some experiences. And you cannot get them unless you let God show his strength in you. When you come to the end of yourself, read that again.
My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness.
Whose strength? I'm not strong enough. Well, you don't have my strength. I've exhausted my resources. You don't need my strength. I'm going to show you my capabilities. I'm going to show you how strong I am. I'm going to show you how bare the arms of the Lord are. But you got to be shown. And you got to be way down low for me to do it. But because did you see it, I must be strong to get you out of this one. I must be strong. Then you know, well, Lord, no more doubt. If you can get me out of this, you can get me out of anything else. If you can get me out of this, you can get me out of anything that might come my way. So no more complaining, no more doubting, no more fearing. If you can get me out of this one, I've exhausted my strength. Now I'm anemic. And I can hardly lift my arm. And now, if you hadn't come through, I'd have been gone. But I'm so glad I waited on you. I'm so glad I prayed through. Praise our God. And now I know that your strength is inexhaustible. There's no limit to it. There's no limit to your strength. There's no limit to your strength. Praise God. Praise God. But now, children, you can't do that because you're taught that. You mean you got to do like Paul? They just keep seeking God here. And don't limit God. Come on, come on, come on. See, now this is the situation. Now, if you back up and fizz out, well, you got to do it again. Or God got to prove something to you. Do it the first time. You keep on going. And not upward. Read a little more.
Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmity,
all right,
that the power of Christ may rest upon me.
Listen, I would rather perish than to demean the power of God and to experience it. I don't want to read about it in the Acts of the Apostles and First Peter and all that kind of stuff. I want to experience the power of God. And because that's undeniable. I can look at those people, might not have been right. They might have been just emotional when they wrote that. But if I experience it, I know. But I experience it, I know. They wrote a book on this, a book on that, and a book on the other. You have that book? Let me read that book. Well, you're going to need more than the book. You're going to need an experience. And I don't care who wrote the book. I don't care who preached the sermon. You can have all the taste you want, whatever else. You're going to need an experience. But because it's way. That might be something that you don't understand. Or they left unsaid. What do you say?
Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmity.
Now look at this of humility. When God showed him and had that prayer, Lord, now, and rather than begging and pleading, I'm going to start glorying. I thank you for granting me grace to hold out and to go through. I thank you, Lord. Now, I'm not going to complain about it. I'm going to glorify it. I'm not going to criticize my shadow. The thing that almost took me under, the thing that just was so excruciating, that's so difficult, I'm going to shout. But when I see what it did for me, when I see the experience that was wrought in me as a result of going through almost y'all, the moon training, I thank you. When I see the strength that you manifest and how far you go to rescue one of your children, and you and that there are no limits. There's nothing the devil can bring that God cannot do away with. Don't wait me. Don't give the devil too much credit. Come on. Yeah, the whole world lies in the dark, and you understand that's because people submit to him, not because God couldn't have done it otherwise. All right. Read a little more.
Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmity.
Lord, now I thank you for showing me. Now here's the situation. God knows this leaving in the darkness. God will show you. He'll make it clear to you. He'll make known his power to you. He'll make known his will to you. Sometimes he will not just see what you want to do, but he will just leave you in the dark and leave you just groping for the wall. He doesn't do that. He will make you see it. That's why you see it. And when, oh, Lord, I see why he did it. Oh, I've had maybe the worst thing I've ever gone through in my life. I could not see the fact God is just because you're trying to destroy me, Lord. That's I'm doing the best I know. And God showed me. I don't know how I'm trying to do it to you, but I'm going to show you something. Now, you, I do all these rough men and not know a lot of inspiration go through it, and you start getting light in your soul. And if I hadn't kept your foot to the fire and your nose to the grindstone, you know, I said, oh God, I thank you. But I looked like you'd been mean to me, but now I see you. Now I see you. And you said, if I had not taken you through that, that you would rather be dead, then you probably would have faced out. Oh, I'm so glad. I get every day when I get a prison guard. That would be 60 years ago. You got to understand the operation of God. Study God. Praise God. This is no joke here. This is no nursery rhyme. Praise God. What do you say?
Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my first.
Lord, I glory in it. No more complaining. No more questions. No more calculating. I'm going to glory in it. Because I know your great hand is available. Your great arm is outstretched. And I don't care how deep the devil might try to depress me. Your great arm.
Glory! Praise God.
That's enough, Lord. Don't give me too much glory. That's enough. I can't take no more, Lord. You'll bust me over with all the glory. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Lord, you may tell me all of this blessing because I went through, because I trusted you. I never could have known this. Nothing. I could have been on 50 days fast and would have done this. Praise God. Come on, let me open this chapter, grab this chapter. Give me Revelation chapter 3, please. Verse number one. Revelation 3:1.
And unto the angel of the church in Sardis,
all right,
these things said he that had the seven spirits of God.
The seven spirits of God.
And the seven stars. Yeah. I know thy works.
I know your works.
That thou hast a name that thou livest,
uh-huh,
and art dead.
And you're dead.
Be watchful,
uh-huh,
and strengthen the things which remain.
Go on.
That are ready to die.
Now, the few little things you have left, you follow me? See, the group is dead. But the little that you have left, about to extinguish your fire. You understand? You're about to extinguish your fire. What you have left, you better strengthen it. What you have left, you've been damaged. What you have left, you better work with it. Because if it dies, that's on your hand. Work with it, amen, praise our God. You've been damaged. Maybe all of us have been damaged at some time or another, in some fashion, to some extent. But now, you better work with it. Because you better try to resuscitate it. You better go through whatever necessary. Amen. Do your exercise and get on the right diet and do what you gotta do, amen. My God, help us out here. To recapture what you lost. Amen. Because if the devil ever get it, it'll be like Fort Knox. You're gonna be able to get to it if you get it. Come on.
Be watchful. And strengthen the things which remain.
And strengthen the things which remain.
That are ready to die.
Ready to die.
For I have not found thy works perfect before God.
I've not found your works perfect before God. Come on.
Remember therefore.
Watch it now. Remember therefore.
How thou hast received and heard.
How thou hast received and heard.
And hold fast.
And hold fast.
And repent.
And repent.
If therefore thou shalt not watch.
If you don't watch.
I will come on thee as a thief.
I'm going to come on you as a thief.
And thou shalt not know what hour I will come upon thee. Thou hast a few names, even in Sardis, which have not defiled their garments.
Listen. All of the apostles around them. All those people just going, giving up, letting down. But God said, listen, I don't care about that, the atmosphere. There are few survivors. They employed, amen, that survival apparatus. And they were uncontaminated. And they shall do what?
Thou hast a few names, even in Sardis, which have not defiled their garments.
Come on.
And they shall walk with me in white.
I mean, they won't be spotted by the apostasy of the people. They won't be affected by the let out of other people. I don't care how close they are to them. Walk with me in white. Few of them. Let me know this, children. I don't give anybody backsliding on you. You don't have to. And I don't care how close they are to you, whatever the case might be, they know you don't have to be affected by them. You don't have to be spotted by them at all. Your relationship is between you and God, not between you and your uncle, grandma, whomever. There's your relationship between you and God. You're an individualist.
Amen.
You're an individualist. You understand? All right, that's what you should hear. Because you see, you can't be affected by others. Regardless of whom, how close they are to you. Praise our God. You understand? What did he say?
And they shall walk with me in
white. There are a few names, right in the midst of all this letting down. All these church groups and everything else letting down. Amen. Not standing where he wants to for an individual all around you. Praise our God. They seem to be doing all right where they seem to be. You can't let down on your saying. Please. And they shall walk with me. Amen. That's encouraging. Know that God has shown them that they were dead. But there were few who were still up there. Amen. That's kind of like a brother some years ago was testifying. And he went downstairs, and there was a mouse that had fallen in a tub of water. And he was trying to get out. And so the mouse was just jumping at him. And so he said, well, I'll just go to bed and come out different out in the morning and drown. And so when he came back that morning, different out, the mouse was jumping. That mouse let him jump, and I don't even know. I don't even know. God, you still jumping, I don't even know. I'm going to be up and
down. Praise the Lord!
Amen. All this confining thing, all these negative situations that come against you, all this stuff that's stacking up on you. If you are determined, amen, to go on after all of that, come on. The worst thing that you can imagine has come against you. Please, love God. The thing that you feel most has come your way, and you feel jumping. I'm going to get you out. Let's go. I'm going to turn you loose. You got to tell me to survive. I'm going to turn you loose. I'm going to let you go. I'm going to let you go. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, God.
Amen. Oh, they were just waiting to see you come out and stretch out and start stealing. God said, oh no. I'm going to let you go. Amen. Give me one more scripture. Ephesians chapter 6. Praise God. Amen. I'm not giving up nothing. I keep jumping to it. Somebody will come along and throw me a rope. Praise God. Amen. Praise our God. Amen. I just can't make it. What do you mean I can't make it? None of us can make it. Amen. But God got the grace. Okay, can you take us through? And you better apply it when you get back in the corner. Come on with it. See, so give me verse number 10.
Finally, my brother, be strong.
Now, here's the recipe. We're talking about survival. Here's the recipe for survival. Come on.
Finally, my brother. Be strong in the Lord.
Be strong in the Lord.
And in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor.
All right, now, here is how you survive. Now, here are the survival equipment here. Now you got to take it, amen, for faith value. They don't just come to church without God to hear it and go about your business, children. Take it by faith value. Go and pray about 2 hours.
Amen.
After God shows it to you. Kneel it down. Make it a part of it. Come on, man.
Put on the whole armor of God.
Now you cannot leave any portion that's uncovered. With that no armor for a back. I mean, you can't run away. You just shut down. Come on with it.
Put on the whole armor of God.
Yes.
That you may be able to stand against the wild.
You may be able to stand against the wild and then you can survive it. All of the attack. But you got to do it, so you got to try yourself. You got to put on the right equipment, and it's available to you. It's available to you. You got to send some foreign out of space to get it. You got to put it on order. And then, by the time you get from Jupiter, it'll be like, God, it'll be, what, 3 trillion years? Come on, man.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood.
We're not wrestling against flesh and blood. Understand that. You are dealing with something that's beyond that.
That's right.
That is a superhuman. Come on, man.
But against principalities.
Yes.
Against powers.
Powers.
Against the rulers.
The rulers of the darkness
of this world. Mm-hmm. Against spiritual wickedness and high places.
All right, come on with it.
Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God. That you may be able to withstand in the evil day.
And survive. That you may be able to stand. You might be able to survive. And listen, children, he gave you the recipe here. We're without excuse. If you apply it. But don't just, amen, just start shouting because you got one good height, one strong point. The whole armor of God. I got a shield here. Every time the devil come, I knock him, you use you off. Got every family drinking. You better watch your legs. Not the sister's dead, yours. Come on.
And having done all to stand.
After having done all to stand.
Stand therefore. Having your loins.
Here we go. Listen, Father. Have you done all this to stand? I just keep standing. Wait just a minute. What did I do? Just stand therefore. Keep on standing. Have you done everything you can do to stand? Just plant yourself. Be immovable. You never have to move your throat.
Yes.
You get it now. Have you exhausted every prayer, every friend you know? You've done it. Now you fasted as long as your body will take it. And you still don't seem to get no results. What did I do? Just to keep on standing. Don't move. Don't try another position. Keep your position. Standing. Stay right there. All of us have seemed to come to the end of our ropes. I just can't take no more. I'm in the class today. I can't take any. We all have come to that. I can't bear no more. I can't take no more. After you've done all the standing, just stand. You know what? And they said the Indians used to be so adverse among the white man that he would not, they would cut pieces of flesh off of him. He wouldn't flinch. I wanted to know you came. I wouldn't want to submit to you by saying, ouch. Do the best you can. You just stood that story. Get that grace in your soul. Devil, you're not going to make me just whine. To that white man, complain. Do what you can do. I mean, have yourself. Lord God, let you go. Please, God. Amen. Come on with it.
Having done all to stand.
After having done all to stand.
Stand therefore.
Just stand there. Wait a minute. I can't pray no more. But just stand there. What did Jesus do? He went a little further and fell on his face. But devil, we need to go into this. I'm going to tell you the truth. This is going to be a series. Go on with it.
Stand therefore. Having your loins girt about with the truth.
Have your loins girt about with truth.
And having on the breastplate of righteousness.
Listen to it now. Listen to it. And analyze it for yourself. Study it. Come on with it.
And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace.
Come on with it.
Above all. Taking the shield of faith.
Shield of faith. Whoa. Above it. Look how you. The shield of faith above everything else. My faith. That's how you perform all those exploits in our Hebrews chapter 11. Come on with it.
And above all. Taking the shield of faith,
yes.
Wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts.
That's how you quench the fiery darts of the devil. I be God. Immediately. That's it. Regardless of what you got, I be God. We will sustain me. I be God to come to my rescue. Whatever the case might be, come on.
And take the helmet of salvation.
The helmet of salvation.
And the sword of the Spirit.
The sword of the Spirit.
Which is the word of God.
The word of God.
Praying always. With all prayer and supplication in the Spirit.
That seemed to be ridiculous. Unthinkable. Pray always. Wait a minute. Not just that. We know that you cannot be on your knees around the clock. We know you have some other things to do. But that's an attitude. That's where you can't get mad and upset like that because you're not spirit. And you can't pray the spirit if you're not in spirit. See, there never should be a time when if an emergency arises that you can't pray. You just scrubbing quality at home and you have a child that's in distress. You can't pray for me. You can't pray for an agreement. You're not together. But two or three together together in my name. Together. You're losing. And whatever you do, you might lose yourself. Come on.
Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit.
This is the recipe. This is the antidote. Come on.
And watching thereunto with all perseverance.
And watching. I have to do all that. You're watching all the time. Wait a minute. That's being another God. Wait a minute. That's not another God. It's impressive. And I feel it, but that's not a God. But God gave me discernment. I can say that's not a God. That's suggestion, not a God. I'm watching all of you. I'm watching the suggestion that comes to my mind. I'm guarding my mind. That's not a God. That's not a God. That reaction is not a God. I can't do that. No, I can't. I can't do that. I got to give and count my words. Prophecy and the judgment, every way you speak. Oh, Lord. You got to give and count. My God. By that definition. Which can be saved. And it won't be explained away, God. God knows the intent of your heart. God knows the intent of your heart. Come on with it.
And watch it thereunto with all perseverance.
And supplication.
For all saints.
All saints.
And for me.
Uh-huh.
That utterance may be given unto me.
Thank you. Feel it for survival. We hope that. That spirit that works in you will not become extinct. There's no species you'll ever see. You might see in the story in some history book or some animal magazine that they pre-existed, but you never see one alive. They're gone. Even the influence do now on that particular case now, or they have nothing to do with it. You understand? Remain. That in this part in your soul now. Finish. Don't give up. But what is it too much for you to recapture? Well, I'm sorry. You can't give up. Amen. Think of God, it's too serious. Amen. Because you might never come back to that again anyway. What you backslide over, you might never even come to the devil make a suggestion. You get afraid. And it might never come your way. You people be in hell for something they thought was coming. It never came. I can't take that. Well, you don't have to take it. It's not coming. God bless you. Now, if you want help, this morning. That's what we're here for. We're not here to do a routine. You have a church everywhere. Bigger church. If you need help this morning. If there is some question mark about your ability to survive, if you narrowed it to five last time, you almost got hit by one dot because you were not covered sufficiently. Amen. That's what it's all about. That's what we come to church for. When Peter and John came to church, they were just coming to say, I go to church all the day. They were coming for me. And they went back to something. How do you know? Because they were accumulating something. They've been going a long time. After they came one day, they said, such as I have, I got it. I go to church every day, yes, they do. I'm not just going for the sake of it. I say I go to church. But I'm going, I'm giving some of you to my Lord. I'm going to talk to this dude. I'm coming, I'm open to God in this truth. Amen. When the last time you witnessed the Spirit of God, it was significant, recognizable. When? Is that enough time to you? It's one of this morning. Family reunion. Everybody who's ever been a part of this congregation. We had to rent another building, a big tent or something. There were those who did well. But there came a time that they did not, resort to what they had to provide. Now they no longer exist. Now they some have a spot. Wherever they live, I said, you come. I was reading about Siberian tiger.